Hi, my name is Victor Bart, and this is my 1965 Unimog 404 with a diesel engine. I have an OM617912, the earliest version without a turbo, and right now it's broken because the engine doesn't get any fuel, or not enough fuel. What I found out is that these fuel lines are really old and crappy, and the hoses are completely with all kinds of damages, and this connector on the hand fuel pump was leaking, but not on the hose part, but on the part here where it can twist. So this was completely rusted, and I already cleaned it and I applied some paint and tried it out, but still leaking. But it is super hard to find this replacement line. If I search the internet, no hit is found, or for $200, way too expensive. But I was lucky to find this line. It's a little bit short, and I found it in the oldtimer Mercedes workshop. They also sell parts, and this was the last one that they had, and the old man that does do the parts really had to go with his flashlight into the parts area and look for it. And he also didn't found it under OM617, but under OM615. So yeah, I'm really lucky that I found it, and I paid 20 euros for this line. That is a good price, I think, because I need this connector, but I also gonna use this new connector. The connectors on this line are still fine, and I also repainted them, but they were perfectly fine, and in the inside they are nice and clean. So this line will go on the spare pile. You never know when I need something of it. This hose is way too short. Even this hose was on the short side. I want to have it a little bit longer so I can make a better run. So what I cut is new fuel lines. This is Kater Barricade. It's super high and very expensive. But 4 meters was 60 euros or something. Shorter pieces were also way too expensive, so I bought 4 meters. And this is 6.3 millimeters, so 1/4 inch. So I gonna use these lines instead of the plastic lines. So yeah, let's fix my Unimog. So here in front of the engine we have the fuel filter. I already replaced the filter itself. Here we have the input, here we have the output, and here we have the diesel retour lines. Here we have the diesel pump, and here's the hand crank pump, and here it was leaking by the connector. So we're gonna make a line from here to the front, and then one back to this connection. So let's see if we can get the hose off the connectors. And in my workshop we have really hot water. So let's see if the heat will help with pulling it out, because if I just pull it, it won't go. Okay, this trick doesn't seem to do anything. I think the lines are rated on high temperature, just like my new fuel lines. Okay, this plan failed. Okay, that worked better than expected, so maybe the water trick did help. That's done. And this line here is not that great anymore. So yeah. I'm gonna replace the old copper rings with new ones. I made a little stainless steel bracket that goes here that will hold the fuel lines in place. Yeah, that will look a little bit better. And in the first design of the fuel lines were like under the filter, so it was really hard to remove it. So routing it this way is just way better. Whoops. The new fuel lines are in and I'm really happy how it turned out. I also changed this inline filter and now it looks like this. And I already cut all the air out of the system. So we have one thing left to do. And that is starting the Unimog. Let's close for around 20 seconds. Doesn't start yet. Not sure what's wrong. Let's inspect it. I didn't see anything strange. I've primed the fuel pump more, so let's see if it works. Not sure what's wrong. All the fuel lines on the pump have diesel in it, so let's see what happens when I start. These three squirt out diesel, but these two don't squirt any diesel. I think this is above my knowledge. I don't gonna open this fuel pump or loosen anything else than this, because that is way too tricky. I need to find someone that can help me. So the smoke around me here is from the engine, from the three cylinders that are still working. So yeah, I think my fuel pump, the plungers are stuck probably, and I don't have a solution for it. So I need to see how I gonna fix this. I really love my Unimog, but not when it is broken. So yeah, let's finish this video here, because I cannot fix it and I need to see how I gonna deal with the fuel pump. And that is expensive, difficult, and if you do it wrong you mess up all the settings. So I probably need help with this. But my fuel lines work perfectly fine, so no leaks anymore, and all the parts are nice and the runs are much nicer of the lines. That is a little success. But now I need to fix my Unimog. So yeah, see you next time. Bye.